start the recording.
Okay, ma'am.
So good afternoon, students. Yesterday we studied osmosis and what is osmosis. Okay, so now we'll shift on to what is photosynthesis and what are the main things go on in photosynthesis. Okay, so in autotrophic nutrition, you'll always find plants. Is it? You'll only find plants or some other things also you'll find in autotrophic nutrition?
No, ma'am, plants only.
Plants, are you sure?
Yes, ma'am.
See, there are some bacteria also that you'll find in autotrophic nutrition. Find them and come tomorrow. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So in autotrophic nutrition, you always find plants plus some bacteria. Okay. So this will be your homework to find out some bacteria and come. So we'll discuss about these bacteria tomorrow. Okay. So do plants need energy? Yes. Do plants need energy?
Yes, ma'am.
Why do they need energy?
Ma'am, to grow.
Yes.
To protect from.
Ma'am, to leave the fruits.
To produce food, ma'am.
Yes, to make fruit, food, and.
And to protect from climate, ma'am.
Yes, indirect that it gives oxygen also. It has to do many processes. That's the reason it needs food.
Yes, ma'am.
It needs energy.
Yes, ma'am.
And how this energy is acquired? Can anyone tell me how this energy is acquired?
Ma'am, energy is acquired in presence of carbon dioxide, water, minerals, and etc. Ma'am.
Okay. So basically, any living organism needs energy, and especially in plants, you get energy by photosynthesis. Now, here the question arises that what is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is nothing but a process of taking carbon dioxide and water. Okay, these two parts, okay, carbon dioxide plus water, and converting them in glucose, that is nothing but we call energy. Okay, carbohydrates, okay, sugars, okay, just a minute.
Not hearing me.
Hello.
Okay, I'm so sorry. Photosynthesis is nothing but taking in or acquiring carbon dioxide plus water. See, carbon dioxide from where you get from air? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
You take it from air, ma'am. And water from where you take?
Water. Nature.
From air plus. From roots, from soil, yes, you get it from air,
yes, ma'am.
Soil, water, okay, and you convert these two both in glucose. Glucose is nothing but carbohydrates, energy. It's a form. See, glucose is a form of energy. Glucose is a form of energy, and you give out what? See, you make glucose, and you give out what? You make oxygen, which is given out, which is given out in the atmosphere. In presence of light energy from where you get sunlight
from sun, ma'am.
Yes, and
yes,
this
ma'am.
Observed yes, by chlorophyll, which is present in leaves.
Yeah.
Okay, chlorophyll is present in leaves. Okay, in that chloroplast has chlorophyll. Okay, so these are six components in photosynthesis: carbon dioxide from air. And then water from air or soil, and then glucose then it is form, then this forms glucose, which is a form of energy or carbohydrate, plus oxygen. This oxygen, it's in little amounts, it is stored in plants, and it is and most of the oxygen is given in atmosphere, and that is taken by who? Us. Okay, human beings and animals. And this happens in presence of light which we get it from sun, and this is observed by chlorophyll. Now everyone, please mute yourself.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Ma'am, without sunlight, plant cannot live.
Without sunlight, no, it cannot live.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. See, if you see some experiments, I think in 9th standard you have in your previous class you have seen experiment. One keep the pot in the dark, and one you keep it in light.
Yes, ma'am.
You have done this, right? One you keep it in dark room, and one you keep it in a light room, and see how the plant moves towards the light, or in a window. If you keep in a window, see money plant, it always moves in the direction of light. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. I'm so sorry. Ha. Now, what is glucose? Now, glucose is energy. Okay, it's an energy. It provides energy to plant, and leftover is stored in the form of starch, which acts as reserve and can be used whenever needed. Okay, so this is what happens. You know, when glucose. See, if you have extra food in at your home, what do you do? See, if you
ma'am, your voice is not clear.
Is it clear now? Hello?
Ma'am, your voice is not clear.
That is maybe because of network issues at your end.
Ma'am, your voice is not clear.
That may be because of the network issues at your end. Is everyone able to hear my voice? Everyone else? Akash Padale?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
See, so many people are able to hear. That means, who was that? Who was not able to hear? That means that there is a network connection problem at your end. Okay? Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, check your network connection, and then you will again get to know. Okay? So now what happens that whenever, see, I told you about, oxygen, that some amount of oxygen is in the plant and rest all is given, the majority of oxygen is given in atmosphere. Now what about glucose? When you have extra fruits, if you have extra fruits for tonight, you eat some and rest all you throw it, or you keep it for tomorrow? If you have extra food, see, there is amount of food today. Like you have 10 apples today, and you just consume one or two apples today. Okay. So will you keep rest 8 apples for tomorrow, or you will eat it, or you will throw it today?
No, ma'am.
You will keep it for tomorrow, right?
Like that only. Nah, plants, what they do, they keep this glucose, the how much of glucose they want, that is their food, the carbohydrates. They use how much ever they want for today, and they keep the leftover in stored somewhere else for future. Processes. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so like that only it happens. Glucose provide energy to plant, and leftover is stored in the form of starch. Okay, it is stored in the form of starch, which acts as reserve and can be used whenever needed. Okay, these are, now it okay. happens with you also, right? The 10 apples are there, then 2 apples you eat, and rest all 8 apples you keep it for tomorrow. You don't eat it. You don't eat it today.
Yes,
you don't throw it, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Example. Now we see. We have seen already seen the word equation of photosynthesis. Let's see the chemical equation of photosynthesis. Now, what is this, everyone? Carbon dioxide.
Carbon dioxide.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
You get it from where? From air.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
That means in addition, what is this?
Water.
Water. And from where you get water? See, basically,
you get sea, river. Sea, river.
Yes, but basically in form, like where you, there are two things from where you get water. One is soil.
From roots.
What is roots?
Yes. Roots. Please mute yourself. Please mute yourself, everyone. Please mute yourself. Now what happens that this water you get it from atmosphere, that is air and soil through what? Roots. Okay. If you're getting the water from soil, that means you're getting through roots. Okay. And if you're getting water through atmosphere, that is air, then you're getting from leaf. Okay. Now this both combine in presence of sunlight. Okay. And that sunlight is observed by chlorophyll. That is green in color, that is present in leaves. Okay, remember. Everyone remember, this chlorophyll is present in chloroplast and chloroplast is present in leaves. Okay? And in combination with these all six things, it gives what? Glucose. Okay? C6H12O6. Glucose is nothing but carbohydrates, energy, sugars. Yes? And
yes, ma'am.
Plus oxygen.
Yes,
this
ma'am.
Oxygen is given out in atmosphere. So this is a chemical equation of
oxygen.
Photosynthesis. Okay? Everyone's clear?
Ma'am, I have one question, ma'am.
Yes, ask. Or you will keep your questions at the end, Akash. Okay? Is it fine? I'll give you 5-10
what,
minutes.
Ma'am?
Who has question? Who has question?
I'm Karan, ma'am.
Karan, we'll keep your questions at the end. First, let me finish the explanation. See, everyone whoever wants to ask the question, please let's keep it at the end. 5-10 minutes, I'll give you. That time, you ask me the questions. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay,
ma'am. Okay, fine. So, this is the thing which goes on. Now, what about trees? See, now, there are some things what happens in photosynthesis. Three things. Absorption of light energy by chlorophyll. This is happening over here. Then conversion of light energy to chemical energy for these all things, okay? It's light energy is there, okay. Right? It's getting it converted into chemical energy in the leaves and splitting of water molecules into hydrogen and oxygen, okay?
Okay.
Reduction of carbon dioxide to carbohydrates. So this is nothing but carbohydrates, okay? Glucose is nothing but carbohydrates. Now, these things... You know, these things need to take one by one, okay? These tips need not take place one after, like these actually will be in form of, you know, these will keep on taking place slowly, okay? It's not like it will take immediately. For now, what happens that, what about the desert plants? This is okay with the, you know, with our climate. Now, because we have water, then light and everything in our atmosphere. Now, what about desert plants? Tell me, because there you have water content is less, right, in desert?
Ma'am, what?
Water content is less in desert, right? Whether it's
yes,
in
ma'am.
Ground or whether it's in air.
Ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, what
yes,
about...
Ma'am.
So how do they manage in desert? Tell me, the desert plants.
In some plants,
ma'am, they store their plant down with their roots. They will.
Just a minute, one person. I'll ask one person. Then you tell me. Yes, Sashi came in. Sashi, tell me. Came in, Sashi, tell me. You were about who was asking?
Ma'am, one plant is there, ma'am. He is storing the water in.
Huh?
That plant, ma'am.
Yes.
And people saw that plant broken and water taking, ma'am.
Okay. See, basically, I'm asking not... Okay, that is a specific plant. But how this process of photosynthesis happen in desert plants? See, for example, desert plants take up the carbon dioxide at night. Okay, they don't take it at daytime. Now, to...
Yes, ma'am.
You know, to take carbon dioxide or to release oxygen, stomata has to open, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, stomata has to open. So to if stomata opens, that means the water molecules will also go out or in will happen. So what happens, the stomata doesn't opens only during daytime. It what happens, it opens at the night time. Okay, and that time, see, in fear of losing water molecules during daytime, that if stomata opens, then there will be loss of water molecules. So to avoid the loss of water molecules, what they do, that they open at the night, and then they take carbon dioxide at night and prepare an immediate, which is intermediate, which is acted upon by the energy absorbed by the chlorophyll during the day. So what happens during the day, the chlorophyll takes the light and stores it. Okay, now now what happens, that sunlight is taken at daytime. Now what you need, carbon dioxide, so that is taken at the night, and water it has, okay, in water it has in it, see, water you get it a little bit from roots. So water you get it from roots, carbon dioxide is absorbed at the night, and chlorophyll, you chlorophyll absorbs the sunlight at the daytime. So these all take reaction at the night. Okay, understood? So in